You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Next up, we're going to roto these brake wires here using point tracking and open shapes. What we're looking to do here is to remove some of the movement of the object to make it easier to rotoscope. We need to separate these brake wires from the background. So I'm going to use some point tracking here, and I'm looking at the areas where the wires connect to the bike. So I'm going to start with this area down here, and I'm going to point track this area, and then I'm going to point track an area up here and combine those tracks into one layer. I'm selected on my Roto demo node. I'm going to change my viewer to foreground for faster tracking. I already have the tracker tab open and I'm selected on the point tracker tab. So I'm going to zoom in here to the area where I want to place my point tracker. I'm going to hold down the Alt key and you can see that in the little viewer to the right is kind of a live update to where my point tracker is going to be placed. So I'll just place my tracker here and I will adjust it for how I want it for the tracking purposes. This is where I can move the search area. This is area around the match area. This is the match area here. And this is the actual point tracker in the middle. If I move the point tracker itself, it moves everything. So I'm selected on my match area here. I think that this gives me enough room around to accommodate for the movement between each frame. That's what you want your search area to be. And then I can start tracking. And what I like to do is I like to track with every frame if I feel like there's a lot of movement in the shot and there might be some motion blur. So then let's track backwards. And then we'll track forwards. I'll just move my viewer. I'll go to our first frame here. I'll just click on the time bar and just track forwards. Okay, that looked like it tracked pretty well, and let's track the other area that I want to track. So I'm going to go up here to the handlebar, find a nice clear frame. Let's zoom in, hold down Alt, and I'm going to place my tracker right here. I'm just looking for a pattern that the point tracker can grab onto, and then I'll zoom out this time, and we'll track forwards and backwards. You can see it reverted back to start frame with the new point tracker. I'm just going to change it back to every frame, click where we left off, and track to the beginning. Okay, those trackers look pretty good. I don't see any bad frames or excessive drifting. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to need to apply my trackers to a layer. I'm going to select both trackers in the object list. Hold down the Shift key, and then in the Point Tracker tab, I'm going to click Apply. And I'm going to click Scaling and Rotation, and click OK. And now we have our layer that has the transform data in it. We look at the timeline. You can see here is the data. And I'm going to name my layer. Double click. Screen left wire. And now that we have our tracked layer, we can make our shape. I'm going to turn off the visibility on the trackers. I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. And I'm going to make an open shape. I'm going to press B for B spline, and I'm going to make some points, put down some points here. Hit the escape key when I don't want to make any more points, and R for reshape. And now I can adjust my points. I'm going to put the line in the middle of the wire. And later on, we'll adjust the thickness of the open shape to accommodate the width of the wire. And that is done here down in the stroke width. But right now, we're just going to worry about articulating the line to the brake wire. Okay, so now it's inside our tracked layer, and let's see how this works out. First, I'm going to go to the stabilization mode and go to the demo and the screen left wire so we can roto in the stabilized view. Now we can see how well our track worked. So while it's not perfect and I didn't expect it to be lined up perfectly, the bottom and the top points are locked on. So now we just have to worry about this middle part and we can do some keyframing. Okay, the second half's done. Let's go back to the beginning. Two new hotkeys for rotoscoping in the silhouette are Alt-Z and Alt-X, while Shift-Z and Shift-X goes to a previous keyframe and the next keyframe. Alt-Z will go in between the first keyframe and the one that you're on. So if I click Alt-Z, it goes right to the middle. Instead of using the rectangular selection tool to select points, I can also shift-click a range of points. I will click Alt-Z again to take me midway through the previous keyframe and the one I am on. Silhouette has tons of useful hotkeys and many workflows to make rotoscoping easier and faster. Then each time I click Alt-Z or Alt-X, it will keep taking me to the midway points between existing keyframes.